Introduction. The class develops the importance and theft of copper from electric vehicle chargers and its consequences. Index. Copper price. There is not enough copper to meet the electric car goals in 2035. Theft of copper from electric vehicle chargers. Implications for fleet management. Copper price. The world reference price of copper has risen to an all-time high. Amid expectations of strong demand for artificial intelligence and the data centers it requires. But prices are also being boosted by predictions of a global push toward renewable energy and electric vehicles. The three-month benchmark contract for copper rose to $11,104 per ton on the London Metal Exchange. On May 21st, the highest level in history, and it is expected to remain that way. The price of copper, a key material for electrification and infrastructure, has experienced an almost unprecedented rise since 2020 in the futures market. China is the largest consumer of copper in the world and represents more than half of global demand for this product, which is the third most used metal in the world. They are followed in terms of largest consumers by Japan, India, South Korea, and Germany. But it is Chile that accounts for more than a third of global copper production, followed by Peru, the Democratic Republic of the Congo, China, the United States, Australia, Indonesia, Zambia, Canada, and Poland.
Learn about our fleet management consulting and training services. Reduce costs and optimize fleet management activities. We electrify your fleet of vehicles. We carry out the electrification plan until its implementation, known as.
There is not enough copper to meet the electric car goals in 2035. There is no copper for so many electric cars. According to the study, titled Copper Mining and Vehicle Electrification, prepared for the International Energy Forum, an organization that brings together energy ministers from 73 countries. It wants to draw attention to the fact that, to give us an idea, 24 kilograms of copper are required to manufacture a vehicle with an internal combustion engine, while for an electric vehicle it is three times as much. In the case of hybrids, they need 29 kilograms on average. In this context, they warn that the lack of critical mineral resources does not allow the total electrification of the planet's vehicle transport fleet. Copper resources are available, but 100% of electric vehicle manufacturing by 2035 requires mining production rates without precedence. The main conclusion they reach is that copper is not being mined at a strong enough rate to support long-term electric vehicle sales goals. Cobalt, graphite, lithium, manganese, and nickel are essential for electrification. But copper fulfills a particularly important responsibility in electric vehicle production. It's found in everything from an electric car's electric motors, batteries, inverters, and wiring, as well as the charging stations themselves. It is important for electrification because of its ability to conduct heat, resist corrosion, and its relatively low production cost, but it does not grow on trees. It is highly unlikely that there will be enough additional new mines to reach 100% electric vehicles by 2035. Thus, in the next 30 years, 115% more copper must be extracted than has been extracted to date. Still, the reality is that there is a shortage of copper deposits of the 224 copper deposits discovered since 1990. Only 16 of them were discovered in the last decade, according to the report. Obtaining permits is the main obstacle. It would only be possible with a hybrid fleet and not 100% electric. The proposed solution is for policymakers to consider a middle ground between now and 2035 to enable the necessary responsible copper production. Theft of copper from electric vehicle chargers. Copper theft has also affected charging points for electric cars for some time, where thieves know there is loot within their reach due to the high price of copper. Copper theft has been occurring in all types of facilities, and especially on railway lines. These types of robberies are usually committed at night and with a saw or shears. On average, what a thief can take for the copper contained in a cable is up to 30 clean euros. The price of recycled copper varies constantly due to fluctuations in the metal market, the state of scrap and demand at that time. However, in general, the price of a kilo of recycled copper is around 6-7 euros, and has remained stable in recent years. Replacing this vital part of the infrastructure can cost up to 8,000 euros, leaving many chargers out of service for weeks or even months. The stolen hose costs more than 1,000 euros. However, this figure can be even higher. Replacing the three hoses of a fast charger can cost more than 2,000 euros, but can reach 8,000 euros. Implications for fleet management. Consequences of theft of the charger hose. There are two main consequences if our charger hoses are stolen from our facilities. Economical. The cost of replacing the hose. Usually, the most important thing is that the vehicles cannot be recharged for a while, and therefore we cannot use them to provide the service, causing economic losses, image losses, and damage to our clients who may even break the contract. Third-party or public chargers can be used, but the fleet will not be able to use 100% due to the time required to recharge the vehicle. First, you have to find an available charger, the time to go to the charger, and the time to go to the place to provide the service. One solution would be to rent or own a diesel generator and use it to recharge the vehicles until we have our chargers operational again. Measures to be adopted. Due to the disastrous consequences of the theft of charger hoses in our facilities, appropriate measures must be taken to prevent theft. Acquire chargers with measures that prevent hose theft, like roll-up reels that hide the hose and unlock only when starting the service. Install passive alarm systems that include audible and optical devices that would be activated in the event of an attempted theft or vandalism. Install charging points in areas that are difficult to access, closed, or even fenced. Have an emergency plan. Where available third-party or public charging points are indicated. Find out who can rent, charge, sell us a diesel generator to recharge vehicles.